I've been doing a series of videos on the death of bluegrass singer Roy Lee Sentors, who sang for Ralph Stanley and the Clenched Mountain Boys. Now, Bill Hurst had been sentenced to 10 years for the voluntary manslaughter in the last video I just made. Now, the Hurst family was well known in Breathitt County. Their name was on the Jackson Shopping Center, and the area's first supermarket was started by the Hurst family. They were well known in the community. Now, in cases such as the death of Roy Lee Sentors, there's typically a civil lawsuit in addition to the criminal case. A civil lawsuit seeks compensation, usually in the form of monetary damages. In a criminal case, the defendant's guilt must show beyond a reasonable doubt. In a civil case, it's called by preponderance of the evidence, which is just a fancy way of saying more likely than not what allegedly happened, happened. Not 100%. But 51% that it happened. Now, Ricky Skaggs offered to provide a high-powered attorney out of Washington, D.C. for Roy Lee's wife, Lucille, for this civil lawsuit. However, Lucille was told by the county court she had to use an attorney from the county she resided in, which was Breathitt County. This had never, ever been a legal requirement. But it happened. Once again, Judge Graham was assigned to the case and once again was disqualified. And, once again, Judge Graham was able to appoint his successor, which was Judge Walter. The civil lawsuit called for $1.4 million to be paid to Lucille, and Lucille was told it would be an open and shut case. But Lucille and her family had been receiving threatening phone calls. Lucille was concerned that the Hurst family would handpick powerful individuals to sit on the jury, and Lucille also knew the Roy Lee typically got paid cash under the table. His federally reported income was thought to be a third of his actual income that he got paid over that year playing music. Lucille did not think this was going to be such an open and shut case and just wanted it to be all over and her family to be safe. So on October 14, 1975, the parties entered into an agreement of dismissal. A $1 settlement was agreed upon to protect confidentiality. Reports were Lucille received $10,000 for the death of her husband. That's it. But Bill Hurst would complain to anyone who would listen that the Sentors family wanted to take everything he had. Now, due to continued threatening phone calls and how Lucille's family was being treated in the town of Jackson, Kentucky, Lucille and her kids decided to move completely out of the county. On November 1st, 1976, Bill Hurst was ordered to surrender himself to the sheriff. But on November 17th, Hurst requested something called shock probation. Now, this is typically used for juvenile offenders for minor crimes such as shoplifting. They'll serve a short period in jail, then the rest of the sentence is suspended in favor of probation, hoping that the experience of prison will shock the individual, hence shock probation. It was not created for circumstances such as this, but regardless, Judge Ralph Walter granted this request. For the murder of Roy Lee Sentors, Bill Hurst served a total of 34 days in jail with a probationary period of 3 years. That's it. Now, there's one set of activities that occurred between prosecutor Dale Bryant, the Hurst family, and Judge Douglas Graham in 1974 that might just be relevant to this case. On June 11, 1974, newlyweds Bill Hurst and Geraldine sold their home to Bill's mother, Edna May, and that was done with a legal document prepared by the attorney for the Hurst family and prosecutor Dale Bryant. Additionally, 11 tracts of land and 2 lots of Bill's were also wrapped up in that deal and transferred to his mom. Edna May then sold those 9 lots of land to Judge Douglas Graham for $1,000. Documents were once again prepared by attorney Dale Bryant, and 16 months later, Judge Graham sold the same lots back to Edna May. But the price tag wasn't $1,000, which the judge got the land for. Bill's mother, Edna May, bought back the land from the judge for $11,000, difference of $10,000. Ralph Stanley approached Lucille and offered to have Roy Lee taken to the hills of home, Stanley's family cemetery, to be buried near Carter Stanley. The family politely declined as they wanted Roy Lee to be close to home. Now later, Bobby Osborne approached Lucille and explained that Ralph had been paying into a trust for events such as this in honor of his brother Carter. The entire funeral was paid for by this trust fund. The memorial service was held in the local high school gymnasium, and it was the same gymnasium where Roy Lee Centers had gone to see the Stanley Brothers for the first time as a child. Roy Lee Centers was buried in the Holbrook Cemetery in Jackson, Kentucky. He was 29 years old.